So the beta for DaVinci Resolve 16 has been out for a little while and I've had a pretty good experience, but there was a thing that I've consistently kept seeing and I was trying to figure out how to recreate it. So I'm gonna dive into a little bit of how I recreated it and one setting that you might have looked over that would fix this problem. So I'm not 100% sure on why this is happening. I'm guessing it's because of a lot of the new GPU accelerated things that were added to DaVinci, but I have been able to recreate it consistently by changing one simple thing. So from what I've been able to gather online, they get this error here by just playing. So I'm just currently playing and I'm not really getting, hold on, let's restart that. So if I just let it play, what you'll see is it's like skipping a bit. Now in the background, I have a 4K file that's a motion JPEG. And then the small image is a HD H.264. So this is something that you'd consistently get and it's an error that is perfectly fine. You can just hit it, but while you're editing, it will consistently pop up. So playing around with the settings, I wasn't able to get this error to continuously keep popping up. It took me a little bit with playing with different settings and doing different things in the program, but what I've come to figure out is if you have a color grade on a shot and then you're on the timeline, you will consistently get this. So what I normally do is when I am editing these tutorials on YouTube, what I'll do is I'll lay everything out, right? And then the shot that's over top, I color grade it right out of the gate because what I end up doing is coming through and then just doing a whole bunch of cuts instead of having all of those defects or linking or anything like that. It's just simple. It's just a workflow that I have. I go into the color page, I throw a power grade on everything, and then I go back and I start chopping everything up. And that's when I started to realize that it's playing and it's playing very, like, it's choppy and the color grade was added. But then I did another edit where I didn't have the color grade because this kept saying correctors and I'm like, I'm on the edit page. It doesn't make much sense. So if I was to then come over to the color page, let's stop this quick and come over to the color page. And all I have to do is just remove all of this. So let's reset. Okay, so now if I go back over to the edit page, and now if I play this, it'll play through perfectly fine. It's not stuttering or anything like that. And it'll play all of these clips perfectly fine. So it has to do with something on the color page. But when I initially had this program in, I was editing nonstop and it was working perfectly fine the way in which I would normally do anything. So that it didn't make any sense at all. And while I was trying to figure this out, everyone kept talking about that they have an NVIDIA card. I was like, okay, well, there are settings for GPUs. Let's come in and go into preferences. And if we come into GPU, we can change the way it processes from OpenCL to CUDA. So now if I go into CUDA, it's gonna make me restart to add those in, but let's do that real quick. And then this is where I really started to figure out why I wasn't initially seeing this problem. Because in 15, if you had a NVIDIA card, you could do CUDA or OpenCL and you would have pretty much the same performance. But now that I'm back in, I can go over and I can add in that power grade quick. So let's add it here and add it to this clip. So now my settings are now on CUDA. And now if I play this perfectly, it'll play perfectly fine all the way through. I could speed this up as much as you want and I won't have any issues here. So maybe this is what, you know, the one setting that might help a lot of people. I don't really have a true reason on why. I don't really know. I do know that Blackmagic is trying new technologies to make the edit page, the performance on the edit page better. But I don't know if you just have to make sure that you have that setting on auto and make sure that it detects the correct card, maybe you have multiple cards, or if you have to go in and change it to CUDA if you do have an NVIDIA card. I wish I had more information on why this is the way it is or what is causing it. I did go in and update drivers, but that really didn't seem like it was a big issue. I do know that with the new DaVinci Resolve, they were saying that the cards have to be of a specific version of the CUDA architecture or something of that nature. That might be something else that is taken into account. There isn't a ton of information out there that I could really find. I know it's not going to be the solution for everyone, and this is the public beta. I do know that 15, when there was a beta and a couple different version changes, that people they're still commenting on those videos. But just to clear it up, this is the first beta build. I do have an NVIDIA card. In the description is all of the gear that I currently am running for this program. If you have similar, you know, you could give that a try and see if it helps you any. If I find out more solutions or more situations that cause different errors like this, I'll definitely let you guys know. But that's all I have for you for today. And with that being said, my name's Jaren. Thanks for watching.